Honestly, I'm kind of burnt out. I've been waiting so long. I guess I've just been watching you loud.
Besties, I am struggling. Ambulance. Not Murphy benefiting from my struggles. Bitch. Okay, ho. Your asshole's wet. That's gross. Anyway, I could make it. That's what she said to you, but I'm not gonna do that. Guys, I am fucked up right now. Not by alcohol, but by my own mental state. Should we talk? I feel like we need to talk.
I need to talk through how I'm. Oh, fuck, you're so far up there.
Okay.
Okay, basically, over the past like 4 days, there's this buildup of me just convincing myself that like all my friends hate me. So that's been unfortunate for me. It's giving me a lot of anxiety, and I constantly feel like everyone's like hanging out without me. Or like excluding me from something, like something's going on, and like not invited. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. Trauma from my middle school friend group. I think that's part of the reason, honestly. But yeah. And then so I just texted them. I was like, I'm sorry if this is annoying, but let me know if you don't like me. It's fine. Just be honest. Just so we can all be on the same page, I won't be mad. I got like no sleep last night, okay? I went to bed at 7:30 in the morning. Do you wanna know why? Cause I had an A-push project for my final. Well, I'm done with school, by the way. But I had an A-push project for my final. So I was trying to do like my A-push project. I left it till the day before. I was trying to do it for hours and hours, but I didn't actually start till like 3 or 4 because I just couldn't get myself to do it. Like I procrastinated till 4 in the morning, that's absurd. And then it took me like 2 hours, so I finished at 6, and I couldn't fall back asleep. Okay, not back asleep, because I was never asleep. So then I ended up going to bed at 7:30. I actually skipped my final class, where I was supposed to present it, but like it was just a recording, so I just like, hopefully that doesn't affect my grade. I could not get my ass out of bed. And then I had my photography final, which was fine. It was just taking fucking photos, it was great. And then at 5, we left to come here. And I was gonna vlog earlier, but I couldn't find my camera battery charger, and it was in my mom's car. My mama had came up earlier today. I found my emotional support necklaces, so I like lost them for a few days. I'm gonna go to bed. It's so fucking hot that it's just stressing me out. I wanna die. This is so uncomfortable. I made these bracelets because like Olivia Rodrigo Sour, my queen, I will die for her. And this one is the one that I kind of just copied the color pattern directly off the website, but then I made this one from Good For You and this one from Brutal, and I have other ones, but these are the ones I'm wearing right now. I have really bad posture. Anyway, it's fine. It's literally like 90 degrees right now in fucking Minnesota. When is it ever 90 degrees in Minnesota in June? Never. Which is kind of fun though, because the water will be warm and it'll be chill. My mental state is not good. I feel like I'm in a state of psychosis. And I also think that I have a personality disorder. Either that, or I'm just a really toxic bitch who just is a bad friend.
Thank you.
And difficult in general. I don't know which one is better. That's not me self-diagnosing, obviously. I'm just saying, I think I might. I'm gonna talk to my therapist. Okay, I probably actually won't, but you know.
I have, oh, bitch, look at him.
Okay. Normally, I'm kind of too alone with my thoughts about recently, and it's really hard for me. My brother and sister aren't here because my sister had work and my brother wants to go on a boat with his friends at home. So they didn't come, and then now we're here. And I don't have anyone to talk to because my parents are hanging out with the adults. Drinking and booze, and that makes me uncomfy. I hate being around drunk people, like with a burning passion. I don't know why, but like it makes me not want to drink ever. Maybe I'm just crazy. No, you're not supposed to call yourself crazy or people crazy. Don't. Yeah, but I like am crazy, so it's fine. I need to do something that'll make me feel better. Maybe I'll watch some Cody Go. I'm like mildly concerned about my well-being right now. In the morning, I'm gonna be like, well, it all worked out. Why? What? I don't think you're supposed to record yourself in moments where you are not well and put it on the internet, but I'm gonna do it because it's okay to not be okay. Fierce. I saw John Green on TikTok. Someone was like, this character was reading The Fault in Our Stars in the MCU, Marvel Cinematic Universe. Which would mean that John Green exists in the MCU, which would make Hank Green exist in the MCU.
And then Hank Green's TikTok was made. So, like, you're watching all this TikTok. That wouldn't mean you exist in the MCU. And I was like, what? And I think I either got snapped or I didn't survive the snap. But, like, it was just too depressing that I just, you know? I mean, like, was that, like, a really big thing after this? That's so sad. Imagine, like, coming back from the snap and then half your loved ones come in a sewer slide. Jewelry check. These earrings. Oh, happy Pride Month, besties. I love how the... I love how my first thought after showing you my cross earrings was to let you know that I'm not... I hate it here. As Kaylee Bryant once said, that would be very hard for me to do. I'm gonna edit all this out. Okay, let's get food. I love that we still have this comic strip up from the year Sunday, June 21st, 2015. It's not even that old. Why does it look like it's literally from the 90s? My mom thought this was the funniest shit ever. She thought this was peak comedy. It's a flower that I drew like 10 years ago, and my mom put it in the fridge because she felt bad that she wrote a phone number on it. And I got really mad at her, so it's been on the fridge. We don't have a magnetic fridge at home, and I love magnetic fridges. There's some whiskey. Should we do shots? God, I fucking need ice cream. Okay, I'm gonna eat ice cream and go to bed. I'll hopefully still be here in the morning. I'm just kidding. It was a joke. Did I manifest that? Is that what the- okay, bye.
Right now it's sitting in your basement, hidden in the back with some stolen art.
Murphy, how are you feeling about this?
It's like 90 degrees out. I showered. It's now like 6 o'clock. My parents went to dinner. I didn't want to go because I don't like going to dinner. I'm going to watch something. Everyone on TikTok was going off about Bo Burnham's Inside. I might try it, see if it's good.
Hopefully this is good. I'll let you guys know. Okay, so I stopped watching the Bo Burnham special because it was boring and it was just singing. Sorry, Thera Stan. But I've been watching this guy at his on YouTube. I think it's CJ the X. Anyway, this guy is makes video essays about like movies and television. And when I'm watching one about WandaVision, so fucking good.
So what's the value of starting at WandaVision, a story that is not actually going to remain a sitcom for the entirety of its run? What's the value of starting it straight as a sitcom? I admire pieces of art that are willing to break form and convention to perform and demonstrate something that we're supposed to understand emotionally and thematically, rather than referring to it with the language that we're used to.
Since I'm nice, I filmed myself playing guitar for you guys. So don't judge me, because I will cry.
Always say I'm never satisfied. I don't think that.
Champagne Problems is the only song that I'm like super, super confident in because like I think that I sound good and then I record my voice and then it sounds shitty. And I know I don't have a very good voice, so please don't cover me, but it's something that I enjoy and I enjoy it. So fuck whatever it sounds like, you know? But you guys like say that you like this, so fucking liars.
Dom Perignon, you body. No crowd, friends, a party. Your hometown skeptics called it. You had a speech, you're speechless. Love slipped beyond your reaches. And I could give a reason. Champagne problems. At his touch on Chevy door, November flush in flannel cure. This storm was once a madhouse. I made a joke, well, it's made for me. How evergreen our group of friends. Don't think we'll say that word again. And soon they'll have the nerve to deck the halls that we once walked through. She'll patch up your tapestry. You always say I'm never satisfied, but I don't think that's true. Cause all I ever wanted was to be enough for you. You've done really easily, really easily. Found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks.
Something really triggering just happened to me. Present for you. Do I go get ice cream? Yeah, I'm gonna get ice cream.
Well, how many figures will it take for you to bring me back my heart? Cause right now it's sitting in your basement, hidden in the back with some stolen art.